Hello, and welcome to today's video where I'll be covering my webcomic process in Clip Studio Paint. In today's video, we'll be discussing Clip Studio Paint's tone tools and how they can be used to add color and unique effects to your comics. Links to related tutorials will be down in the description box below. If you've ever picked up a volume of manga or a comic book and taken a close look at it, you've probably seen that many of them are colored using a series of tiny dots and marks in a method known as toning. This method is traditionally used to make printing more cost-effective for publishers. Rather than having to use many colors of ink, they can use fewer colors in this clustered pattern instead, which gives the illusion of a solid color. For example, when lots of small black dots are grouped together, it can give the illusion of a solid gray color from a distance. Varying the size of the dots can give a gradient effect too. So why is this useful for webcomics? While it's true that the digital nature of webcomics offers artists the freedom to use any colors they like without the worries of printing restrictions, many artists find that the visual style of toned comics has a more traditional and nostalgic look to it. For example, some webcomics are intentionally styled to look like a traditional manga. In other cases, an artist might simply like the unique textured effect that halftones can provide. When combined with color, they can add a fun pop art style to your work. Experimenting with tones is a great way to add visual interest to any webcomic, and Clip Studio Paint's tone tools make it incredibly easy to do. To start, you can find the tone layer effect by going to this button under the Effects section of the Layer Property panel. Clicking this will open up a list of settings that will allow us to adjust the appearance of our tone. While this layer effect is enabled, anything drawn on your current layer will come out as toned rather than your current selected color. As a default, this will limit your tone colors to black and white for the time being, but this is easily adjustable later on. The frequency slider controls the size of your dots. The lower the frequency, the bigger and fewer dots there are, and vice versa. The density setting allows you to change how your dots react to what's drawn on the current layer. The density can be sourced from the layer's colors or brightness, and the Reflect Layer Opacity box determines how the tones react when the layer opacity is lowered. The Posterization box will apply a posterizing, or color simplifying, effect to your layer as you draw, making the tone simpler to prevent visual clutter. The Dot Settings dropdown allows you to switch your tone shape from a circle to a number of different shapes. You can see that by zooming out, each unique dot shape provides its own visual effect. Some more distinctive shapes, like hearts and stars, look really interesting when used at a larger size. The noise shape lets you add a static noise effect to your layer and makes available the noise size and noise factors sliders. Adjusting these sliders will manipulate the noise. I find that the noise factor slider at a high setting makes a great television static effect or action lines for combat. The angle slider lets you adjust the angle at which your dots are grouped. The dot position sliders allow you to nudge your dots along the X and Y axes. If you'd like to use preset tones without having to make any adjustments yourself, the Materials Library has a collection that you can easily add to your work. Go to Window, Material, Monochromatic Pattern, and open the Basic folder. Here, you can find a collection of dot, stripe, and noise tones that can be easily dragged and dropped onto your canvas. One quick and easy way to utilize these tones is to create a selection of the area on your canvas you want to fill in using the selection tools, then click this paste button at the bottom of the materials window. Your chosen tone will be instantly pasted in only those selected areas. You can adjust what areas are filled by drawing or erasing on the layer mask provided. After you've dropped in a tone, you're free to adjust it under the Layer Property panel to get it looking exactly how you want it. Those are the basics for how to use Clip Studio Paint's tone tools to create halftone effects for your webcomic. In the next video, I'll discuss some ways to use toning to make interesting effects, as well as how to prevent issues when exporting toned comics. Check the description below for my social media links and more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.